Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 is filled with a bunch of new features or refinements, and there's been some confusion as to which devices are getting those features. Many people have been asking me, why am I not seeing a feature on, say, an older phone, since iOS 15 is supported all the way back to the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, and newer. So I wanted to clarify which features are not coming to older phones or don't work on older phones. And the first thing you need to know is many of these features that are not working on older phones require an A12 Bionic or newer. That means an iPhone XS, XS Max, and newer. So if you have an iPhone X, some of the features don't apply. However, some of them apply to the iPhone 7, but don't apply to the iPhone 6S Plus, for example. So I wanted to clarify those. And the first one has to do with weather. Many people have noticed some of these nice animations with the sun here, or maybe it's raining and the raindrops are hitting the top of this box here and sort of falling off the edge. Unfortunately, that feature is not coming to older devices. That requires an A12 Bionic or newer. That must be due to the neural engine that's inside of that, the updated neural engine. So some of that requires a lot of processing. Unfortunately, you won't get that nice animation in the new weather app if you don't have an A12 Bionic or newer. Now, the next thing has to do with the camera. And one feature that's really nice is live text. Unfortunately, live text, again, requires an A12 Bionic or later. And what that does is, as I bring the phone closer to something with text in it, it will recognize that text, and you can see the text there. You can tap on the text and copy it, and it will see it. If I switch over to the iPhone 6S Plus, for example, it cannot recognize this text. So if I do the same thing, it just doesn't have the option because it doesn't have the processing power to do that. So that's something that's not available as well. Now, another feature that has to do with the camera is quick take video. And quick take video has been around for a little while, but if you press and hold and slide up on the photo, you can now record a video. And if you slide up and down, one of the new features with iOS 15 is you can zoom in and out. This zoom function is only available on iPhone XS, XR, and later. It's not available on older iPhones for some reason. So that's something that's not available there as well. Now, if we go into the Photos app, there's some changes there as well that don't pertain to older devices. So we'll go into Photos, and within the Photos app, you can see at the bottom we have a little eye. The eye has a star on it, meaning there's more information about this image, and it has visual lookup built in. So if we press on this, it will tell us more about the image, what it is, where it's located, and if we tap on this button here, we can tell what it is, and it will find similar photos to it. So it sees that it's the One World Trade Center in New York City, and there's similar images online about it. If we look at the same photo on an iPhone 6S Plus, you just won't have that option. So you won't have the option for visual lookup, and it just doesn't recognize that information. You'll still get the enhanced metadata about the photo, but you won't have the ability to see more information about it like you can with visual lookup on newer devices. And again, that pertains to A12 Bionic devices and later. Also on the A14 devices, so this is specific to iPhone 12, 12 Pro, 12 Mini, and 12 Pro Max. Within the photos or camera in general, there's some improvements as well that are specific to those devices. So what that means is you have the ability for improved panoramic video or photo. So if you go into take a pano, it says here, or panoramic photo. There's improvements here, so it stitches them together better. It also has the ability to reduce geometric distortion, it handles moving subjects better, and it reduces image noise. If there's maybe a lower light area, it will reduce the noise in the background. Those are specific to the A14 and newer. So those are only on the latest devices. Now with iOS 15, you now have the ability to use Siri and it will process on the device on newer devices. Again, this is for the A12 Bionic and later. And what it will let you do is process the voice on the device instead of having to use your internet connection and send that off to a server to recognize what you're saying. It will process that information directly on the device. The same is true for on-device personalization as well. So what that means is Siri can recognize and understand and improve as you use the device, and it learns the contacts you interact with most, new words you type, and topics you read about all on your device. That is specific to the A12 Bionic and later. You won't be able to have on-device processing unless you have that processor. However, you can still use Siri to ask those requests. It will just take a little bit longer since it has to send that off and then get that information back.
that.
Again, to go along with Siri, but also the keyboard, there's some updates to iOS 15 as well that are specific to newer devices. So if we go into notes, again, if you want to use on-device dictation, it will now do it on the device instead of sending it out. So we can tap on the microphone here and say that this video is about iOS 15 and features that are not available to some older devices, period. And you can see I can continue to talk to the phone, and it previously had a limit of 60 seconds. They've removed that limit again on A12 Bionic and later devices. So unfortunately, you won't have that option to continue to use it for dictation longer than 60 seconds, but those features are available to phones that are a little bit newer. Now, one feature that's available to most of the older phones is spatial audio with dynamic head tracking. If you're using AirPods Pro or AirPods Max, for example, and you're listening to spatial audio or a movie with spatial audio, if you have an iPhone 7 or newer, you'll have the option to use that with head tracking. So it's not available on 6S and 6S Plus, but iPhone 7 and newer will have the option with dynamic head tracking with Dolby Atmos Music, for example. So that's available specifically on the 7 and newer, which unfortunately is not available to the oldest of phones. Now, another feature that's available on A12 Bionic and newer has to do with FaceTime. So if I go into a FaceTime call, and within a FaceTime call on A12 Bionic and newer, you'll have the option to have portrait mode on the photo or the video that's playing here. It's this button in the upper left. Now you'll see it's not on portrait mode. I'll tap it again. And now it's portrait mode. It's blurring the background. That's specific to the A12 Bionic and newer. Also, the option to change the different spatial audio modes has been updated with FaceTime as well. So if you go in and you've got your different mic modes, when you pull down from the control center, press and hold on them, you now have voice isolation and wide spectrum. These are specific to A12 Bionic and newer. And I believe this is a limitation of the amount of processing power that the CPU has in general to not only process video, but the spatial audio as well. So that's why I believe they're doing that. Let's go ahead and end this call. Now, another thing that's new in iOS 15 that's not available on all devices is within Maps. And this one is kind of a strange one. This globe, if you zoom all the way out, is not available on Apple Maps on older devices for some reason. A12 Bionic and later again. So in order to have this map, and this is true on Intel Macs as well with the latest version of macOS Monterey, for some reason you don't have this globe. So this is a dynamic globe. For some reason they haven't included it, but unfortunately they haven't. And that goes along with some other features as well if you're in San Francisco, Los Angeles, New York, and London. Right now, those are actually highly detailed maps in iOS 15, so let me show you that. Now, on the left, I have the iPhone 6S Plus, and that is the furthest I can actually zoom out, so I don't get the globe if I keep zooming out. Now, let's go to San Francisco here and see if we can see any of the detail as well. So you'll see I have San Francisco on both iPhones, and the one on the right you can already see has a little bit more detail. Over the Golden Gate Bridge, the icon's a little bit different. Let me zoom in and show you what I mean. So we'll zoom in a little bit here. And as I zoom in, you'll see that things look a little bit more detailed. So we can change the perspective a little bit, move around, and you'll see it's very detailed on the right. Let me do the same on the older iPhone, and you just won't have as much detail. So as I zoom in, it's not bad. Let me reorient this, but it's not bad, but it definitely has less detail on the left with the older maps. So if you don't use Apple Maps, of course, this isn't a problem, but there's definitely less detail, and that again requires an A12 Bionic or newer for that to show up. Also, something that's coming in the future is walking directions, where you can use augmented reality and it will tell you different locations or landmarks. So that would give you walking directions and then use your camera at the same time to overlay what's going on. So that's something I look forward to, but doesn't seem to be available just yet. But again, that's A12 Bionic and later. Now, one that's a little bit strange that they're not allowing with anything other than an iPhone XS and later is the ability to add a new feature that's coming a little bit later with keys for your home, hotel keys, office keys, car keys, and your ID in the wallet if you're in specific states that will allow it. And so this is specific to iPhone XS and later, and maybe that has to do with some authentication methods, but for some reason you won't have the option to add those in wallet in older devices. So that's something specific to the newer devices as well. Now, something that's a little bit more obvious as to why it's only available on newer phones has to do with 5G. So if you have an iPhone 12, 12 mini, 12 Pro, or 12 Pro Max, and you have a 5G antenna along with the millimeter wave antenna, you have the option in iOS 15 for enhanced connectivity when using 5G. They've improved it, as well as giving you the option to prefer 5G instead of Wi-Fi. So you have those options, but those are specific to newer phones for an obvious reason. Now, the last thing that's specific to some phones and not others that aren't included with iOS 15 is a new feature called walking steadiness. Walking steadiness is a metric that can give you an insight into your risk of falling. So if you go into the health app, you go to browse, and then you go down to mobility. Under mobility, scroll down, you'll see walking steadiness if you have iOS 15 installed. This feature is available on iPhone 8 and later. So it has the sensors that can track movement accurately to know whether or not you might be at risk of falling. So that's something that's specific to iPhone 8 and later. Now, what I've already mentioned are the only features that aren't coming to the older devices. Everything else, including the new cursor that you have, all of the changes to messages and FaceTime and everything else, will be available on iOS 15 on iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, and later. So even those features will be available, but just the ones I mentioned that are specific to newer phones won't be available. So you still get support with an iPhone 6S Plus, for example. So that's great news on older devices. But because of the processing limitations, they've limited some of those features. So that's everything that Apple is not including for older devices. Let me know what your favorite feature of iOS 15 is and what device you're using in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.